For this next presentation, we're going to look at some other water harvesting structures besides the on and off contour swales that we just studied in the last presentation. Those swales are great features for when you're on a hill and ridge forms within the landscape. But what about water harvesting structures within a drainage itself? So before we build any water harvesting structures, I wanted to take a look at how rain falls and flows in a landscape like this. Especially a denuded and barren landscape. We have water falling on the high points, also falling in the drainage, flowing down in the drainage, and if that drainage does not have any type of water retention, then the water just quickly flows down that drainage. In fact, it can bring a lot of soil, it can create erosion, and that can actually bring soil eroding down this drainage. It's kind of like if you nicked your finger, right? If you cut your finger, you would have blood to fill that cut right there. And that cut would be like a way that it drains blood out of your body in the same way that an eroded wash that's not slowing down the water at all is just draining water out of the system. So this is the fundamental problem that we want to solve, and the structure that we are going to look at are check dams. So a check dam is a very shallow little dam that we build with stones or logs and drainage in order to slow down water and deposit some of that silt that's eroding down through there, deposit the silt within the channel to build the level of the channel up itself, build up soil, organic material, and eventually establish vegetation. So I'm gonna dry our drainage back up here and let's build some check dams. All right, so we've put our check dams in. And let's see what the rain does now, right? So when water flows down the wash and hits each in a series of small dams, then the water pools up behind the dams and builds up silt and organic matter and anything that washes down. So over time, behind each one of these check dams, a small little terrace builds up. I'm gonna put in a little bit of silt that's built up, that's washed in from the watershed here behind each of these check dams. So eventually, each one of these check dams becomes a small terrace with a spongy core of silt and debris that holds water for longer, allowing at first for vegetation to establish around the margins. Now, as the vegetation establishes, grasses and different types of seed either wash in or blow in or are deposited by birds that they come to drink the water when this water is pulled up, it grows roots that further stabilize the banks of the stream, starting to shade this watercourse and then dropping more organic matter to further build up the sponge and create this positive feedback loop that actually starts to regenerate the water course with vegetation, shade, organic matter, and slowly soaking water. Now this method can be used to heal the scar of an erosion cut, especially when coupled with off-contour drainage swales in the landscape here that move surface runoff water out and away from the gully. So less water is flowing through a stream that has erosion damage. Now over time, as it continues to rain and this vegetation continues to become established and the soil stabilizes with the establishment of vegetation, that water soaks in slowly. And you may have springs starting to pop up down below these check dams. And as the rain soaks up and builds this subsurface moisture table here, then you can have larger vegetation begin to establish. So, restoring degraded ecosystems can be as simple as beginning with small rock structures stepping down eroded and damaged watercourses. And what that, the effect that that has is to start this regenerative process of water soaking in, soil building up, the conditions for plants being created, and ecological succession bringing a higher order of ecosystem complexity and diversity over time. So we can jumpstart this whole process here with this simple structure known as the check dam. So stay tuned for our next water harvesting technique, where we will talk about slowing down water as it flows down a consistent slope.